We are actually looking for the next pandemic. That is really what we're trying to do. And we're also looking for the weird viruses that may cause diagnostic tests not to work anymore.
All of the viruses that we study really are a plane ride away. It's always possible to have migration of viruses whenever there's migration of people.
The Abbott surveillance program really is a collaborative scientific effort. We work with partners from around the globe. To date, we've worked in 45 countries on 6 continents.
We have an enormous repository of samples that we've collected over the past 25 years. To date, we're up to over 78,000 samples in our program. Abbott's tests are used to screen more than 60% of the world's blood supply. We take that responsibility very seriously to make sure that our tests can detect every type of HIV and hepatitis that could be in those samples. Abbott is announcing the discovery of a new strain of HIV called subtype O. It's one of the strains that's part of the global pandemic of HIV that is found all around the world. Discovering this new strain of HIV is really just the first step. We've confirmed that it exists, and we've shared the sequence with the greater research community. And that will allow everyone to be able to evaluate how it might impact diagnostic testing, treatments, and potential vaccines.
The ability to discover new viruses that could be significant from a global public health perspective, that's extremely rewarding and fulfilling.
The discovery of this new strain of HIV reminds us of why the work we do is so important at Abbott. If we can actually prevent even one infection with HIV or hepatitis, then we've done our job.